Hi, welcome to Table Talks on Today with Paul. Today I'd like to give a special shout out to my number one fan, Callie. Thanks for watching and being so supportive. And I'd like to share some artwork she left behind for me and my special lady friend. Got a little artist on her hands right here. Look at all this fun stuff right there. Who knows, maybe she's gonna end up growing up to be a great artist one day. You never know. That's a great thing about learning and moving and grooving. So here's out to you, Callie. Appreciate the wonderful works of art you left behind. And I know for a fact that you've been a good girl this year. And Santa, if you're watching, you better make sure you hook her up, okay? So the gist of the story today is we're talking about wrapping gifts. Well, everybody knows how to wrap a gift. We got general supplies we need for that. So we're gonna start with some basics here and go ahead and show you what we got. We got three different kinds of wrapping paper over here. There's all different kinds of grades. This is a little bit cheaper, flimsier. This has got more of a little bit foil exterior on it. You see the shine and sheen off of that when I move it around, but yet still paper on the inside. You got this real sturdy, nice looking Lego paper up here. Let's go ahead and give a nice shot of that. That's pretty cool, isn't it? Looks just like Legos you grew up with. Just sturdy paper, love it. Now that was a special buy through those fundraiser deals at schools. You know, you gotta love the parents that work with you, all that. You gotta help support the kids and give them a reason to go out there, go to door to door and learn a little valuable lesson and earn some money. So that's what that one is right there. Of course, you need your tape. Personally, for me, you got two different kinds for the most part. You got this a little bit more of a frosted look to it, and you got more of the clear cut there. You can't even hardly see the bottom of that roller, can you? Well, I love that personally. That's my favorite kind. This stuff so much, well, you know, I'm gonna leave that for the other kids. Depending on your purposes, you might even need a little bit of, what do we call this? Packing tape, yes. Very clear also. We're gonna need, you might want some ribbon, I don't know. Come in handy, make the package look nice and pretty, depends on how much you want to dress it up. You got a little variety there. You got more specialty right there with some shiny sheen right there. Ribbons, hey, what about ribbons? My special lady friend picked up these nice little cotton ribbon bows there. They got the tape backing on them right there. That looks fun. Of course, I think everybody's accustomed to the good old shiny bows like that. Your little adhesive on the back right there, peel and stick. Labels, you're gonna need labels. Adhesive labels are my favorite. Look at that right there, just some good old standard labels. And of course, you can go wrong with a little bit of tissue paper on occasion. So there you got that right there. Today, we're gonna focus on doing just a couple different packages that we're gonna wrap. Set all these things aside for a bit. Lots of stuff to deal with, lots of moving parts. Don't we have all the fun stuff here? But we're gonna do things upright today. We're not playing around. Now, my favorite thing I like to do, let's not forget the scissors, shall we? Well, you can go with a fancy pair of scissors like this. Oh, titanium Fiskars. Wow, look at that. That's beautiful. It even has a nice little sheath right there. Bottle opener back here. I think you can see that right there. Yep. And they even pull apart. Wow, look at that. Fancy. Now, personally, those don't work as well for cutting paper. Just a simple pair like this does fine. As a gift giver myself, I like to pull a little funny on people. And I don't like them to think that they're getting exactly what they're getting. So, what I like to do is make it a little bit of a mystery. So here we go. You know, just recently bought this nice little door chime right here for a new place I'm living in. That's empty. Yeah, well, you know, repurpose and save some of these fun boxes. Maybe they think they're getting this for Christmas. Well, they're not. Fun stuff like that. Now, also, what's been on the trend lately are these little prank boxes. And my special lady friend happened to pick up a couple for real cheap last Christmas. What do we got here? We got the prank gift box. toddler tamer. Oh boy, they got that that poor baby. He ain't moving hardly nowhere. And then look on the back here, they got all this fun stuff right there. But it's just with all the silly products out these days, you never know what you're gonna see. So that's the point of these gag gift boxes. Let's take a look at another one here. And we got the knapsack. Oh, have a little privacy wherever you're at, doesn't matter. Nice little shot in the back of that. That's pretty darn silly, and anyone who believes that's a real gift is in for a real surprise. So fun stuff right there. And I've got a couple gifts here to actually wrap, so we're gonna go ahead and get rid of them prank gift boxes. We're gonna wrap something for real here. So this old doorbell here, and some cologne. So how about that? So we're gonna go ahead and move over here. Love this new table. This new table is amazing. Special lady friend. Nice little sleeve on this doorbell. We're gonna take that off. Open the box here. Oh, we got a little foam sleeve in there. Take advantage of what you got when it comes to repurposing boxes for gifts. That's kind of fun. It's kind of neat, and keeps things from rattling around. Everybody likes to shake their gift when they're getting one at Christmas. Maybe that anticipation, the old guessing game. Well, guess what? They're gonna guess, and they might just be wrong on me, because I'm gonna try to pack that thing tight. Another reason why you might want some of that good old tissue paper I showed you, or a newspaper for that matter. It doesn't matter, it's on the inside of the gift. The tissue paper is a nice touch. More useful for the gift bag, and that's okay. So what we're gonna do, because we're going to use this foam, I'm going to see if I can cut this down just small enough on the inside here to fit this nice bottle of cologne. Let's see if it works. I don't know. We're guessing here. So let's see what we got. Take a little snippity snips over here. We're going to cut it down. Okay, that's not doing a trick. All right, well, maybe there's a good reason I got two pair of scissors here. See, I got one pair that's going to do the job on that. Ah, there we go. I got a nice one right there. Now we're left with this nice to do there. Let's see what we get here. Squeeze that in like so. If we can fit that inside that box, I think we're going to be really good to go. And on top of that, you're going to get here no rattle. So let's give it a shot. Oh. Perfect, look at that right there. That's awesome, I love that. That's gonna fit nice. I'm gonna shut that. It's a nice little, right there. And we're gonna slide it back into sleeve. Okay, so somebody's getting a nice little doorbell set here. Now, I'm gonna pick out some paper back here. Let's move our little table back again. I don't like how the table moves right there. I don't know, I'm digging. You can be as particular and how you say crafty with your gag gifts or your secret lead them astray gifts as you can. I'm thinking I'm gonna go Legos on this. As nice as this is, I think I like this for the bigger gifts in particular. So we're gonna go for this Lego. Now, the big thing that we're looking at for anybody who wants to be very particular about gift giving. First off, my thing is we're gonna get rid of this. There you go. Have plenty of space. Give yourself plenty of space. And we're gonna try to repurpose and reuse gift wrap as you will. Okay, let's roll back a little bit. Now this right here is looking pretty good. Now see, overlap that, and you're judging distance here. Now nothing has to be perfect, but if you have more than less, you're setting yourself up for success. You can always trim away instead of adding to, and that is so true. So we got that right there in the center here. Now all I'm thinking is, if you really want to go for it, go like that. I'm looking on that nice little crinkle there. Just like so. And toss that to the side. And what I'm left with is just enough paper to wrap this. there's the fold. Now, if you're being really good about it, what we're gonna do is, what's the top of the gift gonna look like? Well, if you care enough about it, and that's what I'm trying to show today, I want the top of the package on the non-seam side. And so I've got it flat there against the paper, where hopefully it looks the prettiest. And so here we got this right here. Now this is the step where we need our tape. So, like I said, I'm using this nice clear tape. I want the paper to show as much as possible. Nice little tip and trick on my part of things. I like to tear a few strips off, leave it on the table as such. This makes for faster moving while you're wrapping the package. Not a big deal. We got us 4, 5, and 6. And forgive me, it's been since last Christmas since I've wrapped a proper gift, so we're gonna leave it at that for now. We're gonna go ahead and take this paper here, and we're gonna put it right in the middle there. I'm gonna take one of my strips of tape. Oh, come on, baby. There you go. Now, as particular as I am about it, I'm gonna make this nice and taut. Nice and taut. And part of the reason that I got the strips of paper there, or strips of tape rather, is because once I pulled this paper tight, I've got one at the ready that I'm not filling around. My package is gonna look as nice and tight as possible, the wrapping of it, so that when come Christmas Day, look at that. That's gonna look as pretty as possible. Now the next step I wanna take personally is I wanna start with this seam side. And you pull that corner nice tight. And this is why you want the quality paper, because quality paper, ideally, is gonna be easy to deal with and it's not gonna tear as much. Now look at that, it's not so bad. And then you flip it and do the same thing. Get that nice seam. Now if you're dealing with foil paper, this isn't going to work so well. It's just not going to happen. You're not going to get a nice seam. That foil paper looks real pretty. And I'm talking about the real foil paper. I'm not talking about the paperback stuff that's on that pretty blue and white stuff that we put over there. The real foil paper is a pain in the neck. What you're going to find is when you pull your seam over, you pull your little corner over, you're going to need to tape this right there, just to keep the seam. So we're not fiddling around with that. I prefer this quality paper, this thick stock, and it just seems to work out better. It's got a nice look to it. And the one thing about that real foily paper is you'll notice a very distinct smell on it, it very much so. So if we're being very particular about this, you're seeing how this seam side is like that. Well, that's the first side we're gonna tape up the side of the box right here. Now, that's why we still got all this beautiful tape down here. We're gonna do that right there. That, there you go. And then we're gonna go like this. Well, look at that. I did not leave enough breadcrumbs to get home, as my friend Seth said. So here's what we're gonna do. That's gonna happen time to time. Get a little excess paper right here that's not perfectly straight with the rest of it. So, cutting that about in half, looks about right for the width and whatnot that we need. We're gonna insert that right over here. Top flap down. It's not so bad. Not so bad. Not my best job, I'll admit. Not by a long shot. Now this other side looks a lot better, and I'm much more pleased with how that's turned out. You can see where it can be very hard to judge how much to leave on the side, so you don't have to cut it off. But at the same time, you can always fold those flaps just like so, if you got to. And so that's a lot easier to add into. And in fact, if you're going to make it look as perfect as possible, you're gonna wanna do that anyways, because I think you can see how that looks. That looks very nice. It's very clean. And so there you go. So there we go. We got our cologne all nice and sewn up. Look at this beautiful little Lego package. I mean, he's just gonna think he got him a nice little, well, seeing that Star Wars is hot and they're big into Legos over there as well. Or at least marketing their products through Lego. He might just think he got him a speeder bike from the movie, so who knows about that. We'll label that later. We're gonna move on to the next one. We're talking about repurposing things. You know, you're gonna get some mail every once in a while. Look at the shimmery, shiny package here. This is very nice. I like this quite a bit. Repurpose things, all that good stuff. It's a really nice little to do. I think I got a nice little shirt over here that we're gonna go ahead and pop in here. It's gonna look real nice. And the beauty of something like this is it's gonna fully just keep hidden what's inside there. And look how nice that fits, just one t-shirt in there. And then this is the purpose of our packing tape that we have. Now we're gonna go ahead and seal that shit. Nice thick packing tape. There we go. Gonna hit the upper lip here. And we're gonna go ahead and pull down. Nice. Now, you may have some labels on the packaging. You know, the thing about that's gonna be either cover up with the nice little gift tags we got, or maybe a combination of that with a gift book. That's gonna be the next question of the day. Really your decision, your choice, how perfect you want it to look. Some people don't really care, so, you know. In that sense, go for what you're going for. You know, we got us a nice another couple little to-dos here. Just want to show off. Somebody's going to be getting, a nice little candle warmer here. That's a cute idea. But the other gift I got here that we're going to wrap up, they think they're getting a nice floor lamp. Look at that. What a beaut. And do I have that up? Yep, it's right side up. That's a really nice lamp too. I will admit, I'm going to throw this aside over here. And we're going to go ahead and do this up. Now, what I'd like to do is we're going to pull out wow, look at all this in here. And, we got us a little extra view to add to the lamp on this side. And, oh my, look at all this in here. Well, you know what? After I look through this, I don't really see anything important. And actually, truth is, all of that stuff in there is actually going to be perfect for keeping this next item in check. So, let's go ahead and show you what we got here. We got us a nice red hoodie here. Look at that. Very nice fabric, actually very nice and soft. So we're going to go ahead and fold that back up and go ahead and put that in our packaging here, just like so. Look at that, fits nicely. Oh yeah, see, nice and tight in there. And see if we can squeeze this back in. Good luck to y'all doing this. This is coming together a little bit easier than I thought it would. And we got there right there. Okay, so we got the old lamp right there at the side, and I'm personally really digging this blue wrap for a nice large gift, so let's do that there. We're not going to need this anymore, put that to the side. I no longer need these fancy scissors that aren't going to be too helpful through most of it. I'm going to set the tape to the side for now. Like I said, this is repetitive, and I understand that. But look at this surface area and how well it plays out. Yeah, so you just unrolled the last of the wrap there. But on this one in particular, I know for a fact, that this is going to work out perfect. Just like that. We're going to come in over here and do exactly what we did before. Try to fit that seam right along the bottom of the box there. Now, you can always judge if you got good eyesight about how much more you need on that side, because we're right in the middle over here and you want a little overlap. Take a look at what you got hanging off over here. That's the main thing. Right over here, we got about that much hanging off. So I'm gonna come over here, and we're gonna go ahead and snip where I think. Now, this is why I say I like these scissors just a little bit more, because look what I can do. If I get them just like so, I am just slicing through this paper. Look at that, perfect.